will leave Mauritius, will go to Marrakech in Morocco. That's the venue for the African Handball Under 18 Championship. Yes, we told you that it started yesterday. Nigeria, don't take it too hard at this level. It's under 18. We did volleyball under 20. The ladies finished fourth. Federation says, look, we are pleased, we're excited. Now we know there's a lot of work to do. Alfred, same thing. They lost to Egypt 35-27. I mean, until this board came, we know where handball was in Nigeria. So this is a resurgence, and development is a gradual movement towards advancement. They can get better.
We can definitely get better. Time was when we considered one of the great teams handball on the country, but that was a long time ago. Prior to 2003, when we hosted the All-African Game, from then onwards, you could just say there has not been any meaningful investment in the sport. If you ask tomorrow, emergency, let's open a basketball handball camp, you find out that players who have been playing in the national team since 1999 are still playing this game.
Look at that.
It's not even, it's not been taken to secondary school. It's not been marketed in such a way that we have young stars coming to the game to play. And that becomes it's a problem. So now starting afresh, you have to give they need time to really build the sport. And I think the charge to the board is, to as much as they can, the best way out of handball is to take it to school. The earlier you introduce, and like every other sport, the earlier you introduce the sport to students, everybody's now talking football, talking premiership, talking and rest of it, because it's something that you can feel and get. Yeah. But I always make reference to this in the past. I attended the secondary school where we had a games mistress that didn't like football. She liked handball. I know what she did. She forced everybody.
Okay.
It's a game that I'm passionate about. But she forced everybody to play handball. And how did she do it? She said, okay, at the end of the term, there's going to be inter-class match. Okay. In a class of 50 students, how do you raise a team? It means that everybody, male team, female team, everybody, where you have like 20 students in the club, that means more than 50% of the students must take part.
That's right.
From there onwards, the elite ones, those who can really perform at that level, were weeded out. You know what? After 3 years of that program, we are playing in Lagos State under 12, under 13 finals in handball.
You know what? We need that your games mistress in the handball federation, Samuel Ocheu. You need to get that woman. But good. This is heartwarming. I like the fact that we're talking about handball. I love the fact we're talking about badminton, volleyball. Now they are beginning to see that we need to take the pressure off football, because this is under 18. They are in Marrakech. Remember, they did so well in Kigali, in Rwanda, in the last edition. So now they've lost to Egypt. They're going to play Angola tomorrow. Yeah. You know, federations should sit down, take names. Remember, the league ended in Abuja. It's coming to Lagos now. So when the league comes to Lagos, the league can help us to get players for the national team.
And what it does is that for players who have not made it to the national team, this is one window that you can really get, you know, maximize, you know, benefit of playing for the national team, being an international as it were. And, you know, if that opportunity presents itself, it's something that you can really, when this kind of healthy competition comes up, you find out that players want to up their game and they want to do very
awesome.
Well in this
sport. So that's the update coming from the African Handball Championship under 18 right there in Marrakech, Morocco. So we'll continue to monitor Team Nigeria. The Federation should do the same. The Ministry of Youth and Sport should also do the same. We can get better with it. Let's get on with the show now. On Monday in Ilorin, the Kwara State Capital, we're going to have the Youth Games. Yes, it's very, very important. It's one for the future. It's grassroots development. So at that stage, it's very delicate. So now, Alfred, the talents we saw from the African Youth Games, we would want to judge them again from Ilorin. That's progress. Just to let you know that 34 events, they'll compete in 34 events, 36 states plus the FCT. So you see, this is national business, serious one. We're not playing with this one. Events will take place at the University of Ilorin, the Kwara State Sports Complex, and the Ilorin Golf Course. Look, Alfred, if we start getting it right at this level, our sports will shine.
This definitely is the level to start for. Some of these youngsters, the first time they will make the trip out of their home, out of their states, out of their villages, wherever they stay, and go to Ilorin. What it will do is that it just shows you that, hey, if I can be here at this level, it means that my contemporaries at the end of the day will make it to the elite level. What do I need to do? I need to work really, really hard to, because it's at this point, it's at this level that you begin to say, okay, this is the level, this is the foundation. When you get right at the foundation, you can be sure that getting it up at will become easier, and it's going to be a good sweet experience for those who are taking part. And congratulations to them, because it's not all about winning. And that's where, so that we don't get it mixed up, it's all about winning. It is about exposing these athletes to competition at that level.
It's about assessment. So we look at them and we say, oh, this person did well here. Let's see how we can get better with this. Let's see what we can do with this person. It's not about condemnation at this stage. It's not about, oh, my state won. Yes, some states want to take pride in it. It's okay. But Afre, most importantly, the Ministry for Youth and Sports, they have said, look, we don't want to see any athlete that is above 15 years. It's a youth game, so we want to discover talent. So if you are above 15 years, stay at home.
How they will be able to police that is something that they will really need to work. But I guess their experience in things like this, the ongoing under 17 championship, African championship for West Africa B, is an eye opener. We saw what happened. I mean,
Benin Republic disqualified.
The MIA test just kind of, we know that there are margins of error. But at that point, you're able to say, okay, we are judging everybody by the same standard.
That's right.
And that's why sometimes you hold the games masters accountable.
Just hold your thoughts, Alfred. Before we hold them accountable, hold yours. Let's go on this quick break. When we come back, we'll continue with the youth games. So don't go anywhere. Stay.